Hello everyone. Today I'm going to discuss my interview experience for Capgemini for analyst profile. Before starting, I would like to thank Anshul and Tech and Target for providing such a great content to us. It consists of all the information about job, internships, exam pattern, and interview experiences. It helped me a lot. Before my interview session, I joined Tech and Target, and it really helped me a lot. Moving on with my interview experience, I would like to share about my technical interview first. The first question I was asked was, tell me about yourself. In this, you have to tell about your education in a chronological order, and then about your summer internship or the projects you have worked on, your hobbies, your interests, and your technical skills. Then she asked me about my internship, which was based on IoT. She asked me about the projects that I have made during my summer internship. And she also asked about the projects that I made at university level. So all in all, my interview was based on the projects that I worked on. And as I've mentioned in my resume that I was skilled in Java and SQL. So she asked me one question about Java, that was the difference between OOPs and procedural programming language. And the next question she asked me about SQL, that was what is normalization and what do you mean by 3NF. So this was all about my technical interview. She said that she was done with her questions and if there was any query. So I asked about what kind of work I have to do if I'll select for this particular position. Then she told me about few things about this particular position, and this was all about my technical interview. She asked me to wait for 15 to 20 minutes for my HR interview call, but I got that about an hour later. So my HR interview, this is all about my HR interview. First question I was asked was, tell me about yourself. Then he asked me that how I was feeling with this whole lockdown thing, whether I was happy or not. So obviously I told him that it was not quite good thing because I was missing out my final year. And then he asked me how I made my lockdown productive. In this I mentioned about all the certification courses I did during my lockdown period. And then he asked me why Capgemini. So in this I gave him about answer that that was totally flattering. So you have to just praise Capgemini. You have to say every good thing about Capgemini in this particular answer. And since I am from EC branch and I was applying for an IT industry, so he asked me that why you are doing so, because why you are not waiting for the core company and applying for an IT industry. So I told him that software and hardware works hand in hand, and I've already worked on hardware, so I was quite interested in working on software things. So he was quite satisfied with my answer. And then he asked me to answer a few questions in a yes or no manner. So he asked me about if I was okay with the night shift, then say yes. Even if you are not okay with the night shift thing, just say yes, because they want to know about your mentality and all. So the next question he asked me was if I was okay with relocation. Say yes again. And there's a 2-year bond, and are you still willing to work in our company? Again, say yes. Gap in education. There was 1 year gap in education. So he asked me why I took that particular gap and how it went. So that's all about this gap in education question. And then he asked me about what were my plans for masters. Don't say that you don't want to do anything in PG course, and neither say that you will leave the job for doing masters. You can say that you want to do a master course, and there are many online certification courses also that you can apply for. So you just want to be updated according to the technology. So that's how you should answer this question. And then he was done with his questions, and he asked me if I want to ask him to anything. I asked him about the work atmosphere, about the company, and how it was going to work, and how work from home was going on, and about the company stats. Then he told me some really good answers about all of it. And so yes, this is how my HR interview went. So, yeah, thank you.